piace a te. Don't do that. But do it in two. Right? Start legato. And then click. Back to legato. So start legato, staccato in the middle two bars. So the fa, sol, mi, re, that's the legato.
Fa, sol, mi, re.
And then you're going to be staccato on beat two of that bar. Two, da, 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 and then bend back. Yeah, start at 3.
Oh,
yeah.
I thought you wanted me to start at the beginning.
No, just everybody play the melody starting at measure 3.
Do you guys remember that Price is Right game, Pachinko?
Yeah.
Yeah? And how there's those like little metal pins, and the thing goes down and it sort of like rattles across those pins. I imagine that there's like each of those syncopations is one of these little pins. And so as I'm conducting the legato, I'm click, 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 click. It's like I'm brushing past those each time.
Okay.
Right? So that pulsation is in the legato beat. Okay, now try that. Start staccato, and then conduct legato, but still listen for the accompaniment. Everybody in parts. Starting at the beginning.
There's no rebound, that's called melding. Okay, melding is when you basically move from one beat right into another. That's really, really effective if people are holding long notes, or if there's not a lot of motion, or if you're trying to show really, really sustained with no sense of pulse, it's great. If there is pulsation, there needs to be some rebound. Okay, all right, who's next? Just under the wire. Which one do you want to do?
I'm going to do the second one.
Okay.
By that, I meant the highest.
Yeah, all the ideas in there. Yeah. I actually like the legato staccato change. That's really good. I don't see the change in Ben-Am. Prep that fortissimo, and then just don't lose track of where you are. First.